He knows my name. He just almost called me Stephanie. All right, thanks, Kim. Well, the Burlington area is the first site chosen for a three-year-long relationship between American police departments and their counterparts in Iraq. Law enforcement officials from that Middle Eastern country are on a tour of the U.S. as they try to upgrade their own security. News Channel 5's Jack Thurston has more.
Last week, the Vermont State Police barracks in Williston became a classroom. The students were visitors to the United States.
These guys are true heroes.
They are officers with the Iraqi National Police in Vermont for the first of a series of training missions.
So what I will typically do is...
The International Association of Chiefs of Police, or IACP, got a $5 million State Department grant to train Iraqi officers. In crowded Baghdad, where bombings and assassinations are all too common, the police say they're struggling to catch up with the modern world. Because of Saddam Hussein's dictatorship, they describe a life put on pause for more than 20 years. There are so many established police techniques that are new to them.
We learned about all the advanced technology and equipment they use. We'd like to use that when we go back to Iraq as well.
An eyewitness account.
The IACP calls this planting the seeds of democracy. Updating how Iraqi officers interact with the public could help break down fear of or violence toward officers.
The Iraqi people are the same as us. They want freedom, they want jobs, and they want the government to work for the people.
The Iraqis have left Vermont, but more could be coming down the road. This grant continues for several more years, with more delegations visiting small towns and big cities all across the country.
It's a long uphill climb for the Iraqi people, and these national police officers hope their lessons in the U.S. can help them get to a more peaceful future.
To live our lives normally without fear.
In Williston, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.